that he's given the team respect, and they know that if they mess with the players on his team, never mind whether it's Matt Sundin or anybody on the team, that they're going to eventually have to deal with Ty.
His job is to go out and play intense and be a part of that hockey game, but at the same time, needle people. Get under their skin, get them off their game, and he's good at it.
How old are you, 32, and I'm 22. 10 years difference, and I make double what you make. Ah! Getting like that your whole career. Hold on. Bob McGill pumped the other night. I seen it. They give you so many lefts, you're begging for a right. Yeah. Hey, I don't care if I win one. That's not f***ing to me. I don't care. I fight for my team. I'm not like you, you selfish. Want to go as soon as we get out? Razzle dazzle.
Ty and Jonathan could do the same thing. They could go like that till they get tired and let this here one go and then grab a hold and switch right over and be just as effective with his left, which how many guys can do that? And it really throws the other guy off because he can only throw a right, and that's how he wins most of his fights, is because he can switch hands.
I got a lot of respect for Ty. I mean, for being a guy that's, I don't know, 5'10", for a guy his size that can handle himself like he does, I got a lot of respect for him.
He's just a smart fighter. He likes to spin sometimes. He likes to stay back and throw the bombs. You know, he can hold on with the best of them, or he can just throw toe-to-toe.
If they mention my name and say, you know, that kid works hard out there, maybe not the most talented, but if they know I give it my all out there and they got their money's worth, then that's pretty satisfying. Matt's and I are the only guys left in Toronto now that since we